and welcome back to our channel. For today's video, I'm doing a toy rotation video. I decided to start doing toy rotation because Finnegan, who is on my lap, really is busy now. He needs a lot more attention than normal. I decided to do toy rotation. You can see a little bit behind me. I wanted to show you guys how we're doing toy rotation since we don't have like a designated playroom. This is just in our living room, and I feel like this will be easy to show you guys because we don't have like that big of a house, so a lot of things are just like hidden in plain sight, I guess. So I'm gonna show you guys our little play area. So from afar, this is Finnegan's little play area, and that block just rolled underneath the TV stand. I'll get that later. Let me first just say, like, this is like the biggest room in our house. Well, actually, like, our bedroom probably is the same size because it's above it, but this is our living room, and I'll do like a little pan, like that's our front door, and then TV stand, play area, and then like our couch and stuff, and then we have a foldable bike too, even though we have like a whole gym downstairs, whatever. So this is Finnegan's little area. All right, so this is a little play area. Finn is super vocal today, I'm not too sure why, but he is in his walker right now. I'm kind of gonna speed through this. First thing I want to say, he has like little puzzles there. I don't think that they're gonna stay here forever, but he really likes these like Melissa and Doug like puzzles. By the way, he is 8 months old, in case you have an 8 month old and you're looking for toy ideas. First thing over here is the wall. I put these like little rainbow decals that I actually got at Five Below yesterday. All of them were $5, which I think is pretty good. But I don't know how I feel about the placement yet, but I'm just gonna leave them there, and then they're easily movable, so I can like move them around. But I think it looks cute, and yeah. And then also the playmat is from Aldi. I will warn you, this one we've had for since like we moved in. There's like a tear in that corner. So we did order another one on Amazon. I think it's supposed to come either this week or next week, but it's just like a plain one that I think has stars on it. It's like gray and stars, because we want to put it this way. This one is like half the size of it is, like it's doubled up, but we only did that because there's like a tear in the corner, and I would really like it to come more this way, just because he has a tendency of falling over. He can sit up, but he like when he reaches for something, he falls over and bonks his head and it hurts him, so I want to protect it mostly. This little 4-cube thing is from IKEA. So now I'm gonna like speed through the toys. This thing, I can never remember what it's called, is from IKEA. He's definitely too young for it, but he can move the things, which is fun and everything, but it also does kind of like fall down. Then I have this camera for him. This is from Target. These three cars are from Primark. This thing is from Amazon. He likes this. And then he has some pacifiers. These boots are just like what we use when we go out. And then Brendon's grandmom got him this like star thing, which he has like, it does like sounds too. We rarely use it down here, but like we have like a sound machine and everything in his room. So it's like cool because it can make like the whole room have stars on it. So we put that there just in case like he's overstimulated one day. Here, since I'm up close, I can show you the little holes. Like there's like multiple, so they're definitely not safe for Finn just because he can like put everything in his mouth right now. All right, so I try and do like the monastery play. Obviously, like monastery isn't really this, like monastery is like activities and everything. All right, so Finn's gonna talk in the background. He's part of the video, so. This first shelf has like this Muslin Doug thing that like moves. We just got this toy for him, so he hasn't really played with it, but he does like to take them off. We gave it to him for like a minute. Then he has this skip hop guitar, pretty much all it does. And then he has this shape sorter, which he is only 8 months old, so he's not sorting the shapes, but he just like, we just give it to him with this lid off and he takes them off. And yeah. So, and then this shelf, these are Love Every toys. We no longer do Love Every. Well, we stopped it because he wasn't really playing with anything. And now he's playing with them, so I don't know if I want to like re-up the thing, but whatever. So those are all our toys. And then these are mushy stacking cups that I got from TJ Maxx. And in the back, it's like a VTEX block that is battery operated, which we are trying to stay away from, but regardless, it's a good toy. Then down here, I got these bins from Target. And then this one I have a lot of books in. I'm really trying to get into reading to him more because, I'm not gonna lie, I didn't really read to him until like now. So yeah, and he really likes the books that have like these thingies in it. He loves this book. I got this for him for Valentine's Day yesterday. So yeah. And then we got him this book yesterday, Little Giraffe, that is the same thing. And then Mary Had a Little Lamb. Try and keep like all board books down here because he can actually play with them. And then this last bin, also from Target. This is from Moana. He's never seen Moana, but I was at Five Below yesterday when I got like those rainbows, and this was cute. So I got this. I like Moana. Then, and like more Love Every Toys. He just started playing with this. It's like a Weeble Wobble, so it moves. Then he has never played with this, but I figured this was a better toy to learn how to like. I mean, I'm not gonna assume he can catch or anything, but like throw at, like touch and feel everything. And then this is from, I wanna say like 3 to 4 month box, but it's like a good like sound making thing. And then Brendon's aunt just got this for him. It is this little like my first fish tank. So like every little fish has like its own thing. Like this one crinkles, this one, I guess, just does that. And then this one is a squeaker, which my dog's probably gonna freak out about, so yeah. But this is his little toy shelf. Obviously it's not like completely toy rotation because there is like more than one toy on each shelf, but you know, like sometimes the kids need a little bit more entertainment than like 4 toys, you know. So yeah, and I know also other people have like the lot bigger ones, which if I did have a like, bigger space to have, I probably would have a bigger like shelf, but this is just like the 4 thing from IKEA that I feel like everyone has. It's like the Calyx brand. But yeah, we still have to mount it to the wall, but he's not really moving it, so we have a little bit of time for that. Okay, I had to pick up Finn, so if this is shaky, I'm sorry. Then we have the Boppy on the ground. I never nursed, well, I mean, I did exclusively pump for 12 weeks, but I never used, like, the Boppy, and I was like, well, this is a waste, but now we use it so much to putting behind him when he's sitting up. He kind of sit up independently, but he gets distracted sometimes with toys, and then he'll fall, and he'll, like, hurt himself, so we use that. And then also that helped with, like, tummy time, because he hated being on his stomach. And then this is a walker. I was completely against walkers. I still kind of am. I don't use them 24/7. I just place them in there for a couple minutes if I have to run to like the bathroom or something. But yeah, I mean, obviously everybody can do whatever they want. Do I think that like putting my kid in a container is at all effective? No. So that's how I feel about that. Then there is a book on the ground. Cooper just laid in his new bed, so like that's so adorable. And over here, this is like a playpen. It's like a hexagon. I think I've shown it in other videos, but this has like really saved the day when I have to do something and I can't like contain Finn because he is mobile now and he moves fast. So yeah, that's really nice. I'll try and link that down below. And as for where we keep all of his other toys, these are all like single use toys. This is a massive basket from Home Goods. It was like $19. But I just shoved all of his like single use toys, like something that he can chew on. And he is a little bit too young for this like Noah's Ark thing. So yeah, he has all of the single use toys. Well, like not single use, but like one use for them. Toys, and we also grab from here when we are leaving just for some car seat toys. So yeah, I would recommend this if you have a lot of little toys, just like getting a little basket and or a big basket like this one and just shoving everything in there. And then also, like, if he ever gets tired of all the toys in his play area, I'll just, like, grab a couple toys and, like, give them to him, you know? And then last thing for toy rotation. So this thing is a chest. The top opens. I have to hold my child right now, so I can't open it. But I just have, like, a couple bins of toys that he's either too small for or just toys that I can rotate that are also, like, bigger toys that can go over here. But that is our whole toy rotation for right now. I did set this up yesterday, so it's very, very new. But if you guys would like any more videos about this or any toys that I recommend for babies that are learning how to play. Also, I want to say that I'm not technically a like professional in this field. I did go to school for early education, so a lot of things that I know are based off of what I've learned in school. Sorry, Finn is like really talkative right now. But also there is a plethora of videos on the internet of like things that are very good for like 8-month-old, 7-month-old, 6-month-old, and so on. So look that up on YouTube if you really want to know. But I will do videos on what I'm using. So if that's any interest to you, I would recommend subscribing down below. But I will see you guys on Thursday. I, again, really apologize for the child. I fully meant to wake up early and come down to this by myself. And then he decided, oh, you're up? I'll get up too. So, yeah. But I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you on Thursday. Bye, guys.